Hi everyone, I hope you are having a wonderful weekend. Welcome to the Daily Life Show. Today I'm gonna bring you one of the easiest recipes to make a berry jam in Facebook Live. It requires a couple of minutes, that's it. And jam is something that we all love, right? We like to put it on top of our toast and even on top of our chia pudding, everywhere. I love it, but it's really difficult to find a good berry jam or any other type of jam at the supermarket because they are usually really high in refined sugars. And sugar, remember, has 61 different names of the sugar that we have to avoid in any label, like corn syrup, fructose corn syrup, molasses, sugar itself, agave, because it's pure fructose. And the problem with the sugar is that it's giving spikes of insulin and you can end up with insulin resistance. And only part of the glucose that we absorb goes into energy. The rest goes into triglycerides and cholesterol. So we start storing a lot of the fat that we want to eliminate from the body. So it increases the risk of cardiovascular diseases and obesity. So it's very important that please, when you go to a supermarket, start reading labels for sugar. And one of them is when we go to buy jam. So as I said, it's almost impossible to find a clean jam when you go to a supermarket, but it's really inexpensive and very easy to make at home. And I wanna show you today how. So I have a mix here of berries. So you can use fresh berries or frozen berries, but what is a must is that the berries have to be organic because it's in the list of the fruits that are full of pesticides. They are full of pesticides. They add a lot of pesticides into berries. And just washing with the vinegar and water is not enough to get rid of all the pesticides that go in the fruit. And they are endocrine system disruptors, so they imbalance your endocrine system, they cause a lot of inflammation. So berries is one of the fruits that is a must to buy organic. So it can be, as I said, fresh or frozen if it's less expensive for you. If you use them frozen, try to thaw them before and then eliminate the extra water that the berries are releasing during the process of thawing. So then what we do, we are gonna add the berries in the blender. We add, I'm gonna prepare 1 cup of berries. And then to the cup of berries, we are gonna add lemon or lime juice, whatever you prefer and is your favorite, because they are both really good for detoxifying your liver, alkalizing your body, and boosting immunity because it's full of vitamin C. But also why I like to add the lemon juice to the jam is because of the amount of citric acid. So it's a really good natural preservative. So we are gonna add the juice of half lemon or a small lemon. That's what I've been squeezing. Then we have to put our favorite sweetener. So if you wanna go into a really low carb diet, we have to go for sweeteners that have a zero or almost non-glycemic index. So it's not giving spikes of insulin or increasing the sugar in blood. So my favorite is stevia or monk fruit. If you don't care about going strict into a low carb diet, I still suggest that you switch from regular sugar into natural sweeteners. So you can make it with honey or even coconut sugar or coconut nectar, which is lower glycemic than honey. If you use honey, you have to use raw honey, so you have a lot of enzymes, it's a natural antibiotic, and raw means hasn't been processed. And it has to be from wherever you live. If I live in Hawaii, it has to be Hawaiian honey. You live in Boston, you use honey from Boston. So why is that? It's because the bees, when they take the pollen, part of those antigens go into the honey. So when we take the honey, our immune system is creating memory. So then, thank you, Mihai. Thank you for connecting. Thank you. Let me know whatever question you have. I'm happy to help. So what I was saying about the honey is that the honey has to be local because it's creating memory in our immune system. So what happens is that it's preventing us from seasonal allergies. So a really good way you have allergies to pollen is to eat local honey, because it's gonna give a boost to your immune system. It's gonna create memory. So whenever the flowers are blooming, you may not have the same reaction that you used to have before, because your immune system is already prepared. You get immunized, right? So honey is a really good sweetener for your jam. But as I said, today I'm using a really low carb sweetener, because here at home we are going now into a really low carb diet, because we wanna learn how to use our body. I want my body to learn how to use fat as a source of energy instead of sugar, so that in that way we decrease the risk of getting a lot of disorders, diseases, and also getting weight, if that is something that you are looking for. It also helps in getting more endurance if you are an athlete, for example, or a marathon runner, because we get more endurance when we burn fat more than when we burn sugar. Is why a person that is adapted to eat sugar, a lot of sugar, you need to eat every 2 hours because your body is asking for it. But if you are adapted to burn fat, you can be like for 6 hours or even more, like an intermittent fasting, like even for 16 hours without eating, and you are okay, and you are not gonna be starving, and your body is gonna start using the fat as a source of energy. So it's why in this jam I'm gonna use stevia, a zero glycemic index sweetener. So stevia is much sweeter than sugar. Usually for a cup of sugar you use about 1 teaspoon stevia. So for this I'm gonna use maybe 4 drops, and you can always rectify after, you can always add more. So then I added in my blender 1 cup of berries. They were frozen before, so I thawed them, I got rid of the extra water, and now I'm gonna add 4 drops stevia. And stevia has to be pure, 100% pure. Try to avoid any kind of alcohol or any other type of added sugar in the label. Please read the labels, because that's the way we get cheated by the food industry. So it's why it's increasing the risk of a lot of diseases. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna blend the berries with the sweetener. So now is the annoying part, because Vitamix are really noisy. So I'm gonna blend it well. So I'm gonna put it in medium speed. Okay, let's do it. That's it. So when we have already a puree, let me see, you can see, I'm gonna pour it in a container. You have a puree of your berries. I would suggest that you already put it in the container where you are gonna keep it in the refrigerator, an airtight container, always glass better, because plastic usually has a lot of BPA, and BPA is also an endocrine system disruptor. It's really toxic for our body. It's even increasing the fertility issues right now. So try to avoid BPA. You buy any type of plastic container, you have to see BPA free, or a can. It has to be BPA free. So, hi Lashonda. Difference between drops or powder. You can add stevia in the powder form. That is totally fine. Yeah, either way is fine. It has to be pure. That's what is important, that both the powder or the liquid form are both clean. Okay? Yeah. So I'm gonna add the puree in here. It's good like this already. And then, how I'm gonna make this puree solidify. That is the secret, how you are gonna make jam. So, the way we are gonna solidify the jam is with chia seeds. And chia seeds is a superfood. It's in the group of the the superfoods. The superfoods are foods that are really rich in vitamins, minerals, omega-3 or 6 fatty acids, or they have a complete protein by itself. So why I love chia seeds is because chia are really rich, as I said, in omegas, which is the anti-inflammatory fat, the one that we want to put in the body. It has a lot of protein. One tablespoon of chia is already 5 to 10 grams of protein. So it's a complete protein. You don't need to add any extra protein when you have already a lot of chia in your meal. But it's also really rich in fiber. It's really, really high in fiber. So when you put the chia seeds in contact with liquid, it's gonna absorb the extra moist, so it's gonna become kind of like a pudding consistency. So this is what is gonna give the trick of the gelatin consistency to our jam. So I'm gonna add for this match maybe 1 tablespoon of chia seeds. So I just added 1 tablespoon of chia seeds here. I'm gonna mix it all well. Be sure that the chia go all over your jam. Mix it. And, oh, it's still stuck. The chia gets stuck to everything. So be sure that you put the whole tablespoon, you shake it. So now we have the chia all over the berries, but it's not ready to eat because the chia seeds didn't absorb still any liquid. So what we do, we close it, airtight container, and we put it in the refrigerator for at least 4 hours. 4 hours to overnight, and you will see that whenever you are gonna use it, it's gonna have a more gelatin consistency that it has now. So it will be ready to eat. As you can see, very, very inexpensive and really simple, really simple. So I hope you give it a try because you are gonna love it, and it's even tastier than the ones that you buy at the supermarket because the ones that you buy are just pure sugar. There's not even almost berries in there. And when you make a puree, a smoothie or a juice, you have to drink it within 24 hours, because after 24 hours it lost a lot of the nutrients, a lot of the antioxidants that you have within the fruit or within the vegetables. So you have to drink it within 24 hours. So a berry puree that you buy at the supermarket that has been on a shelf for months, that means that the only thing that you have left is the sugar plus the added sugar that it has in there. So it's why it's really simple to make. I made it. It's because I talk a lot, so it took us longer, but this requires just 2 minutes. You blend the berries, the lemon juice, and the sweetener, and then after just mix it with the chia seeds and put it in the refrigerator. If you have a lot of liquid in your frozen berries, what you can do after you mix it with the chia, if you think there's too much liquid, you can cook it for 5 minutes. Until the liquid reduces a little bit, and then you put it in the container and refrigerate, and that's it. So please give it a try. I would love to hear how you like your berry jam in the comment section. And this is just an example of how simple it is to shift into a healthier lifestyle. And eating healthy doesn't mean you have to spend a lot of money, and this is a really good example.